All right, well, that was James Wilkinson joining us there with the latest in on all of that news there. Let's move on because we have Adam Ford. He's going to tell us a bit more about this renaissance of, afoot over in Western Australia in the Perth capital, and the city really getting a complete makeover for the 2029 bicentenary there. Let's bring in Adam Ford, editor of the Big Bus Tour and Travel Guide, who joins us now to tell us a little more. Adam, thank you very much for joining us, and perhaps we can just start off with Perth, the new inner city Perth there, some of the executive places to stay, because I know that the city has welcomed a whole swag of new hotels in recent months.
Yeah, Leanne, there is so much going on in Perth. It's a bit controversial this week. There's a lot going on in Perth. But in the inner city, in terms of hotels, lots of great news to share. And, of course, James just mentioned some of it there. But one of the big highlights coming up in early 2018 is the opening of the Mega Western Hotel, which will be located on Hay Street. It looks absolutely sensational, I've got to say. A couple of hotels that have just opened recently, though, that are also well worth a look. Firstly, Pepper's King Square Hotel on the northern edge of the city grid, just opposite the King Square development, which is under construction at the moment. I think this hotel has really brought boutique luxury hoteling to the Western Australia capital. You walk in on the ground floor, you've got a very sort of funky bar, restaurant, cafe area, lots of industrial styling going on. And then up in the guest rooms, beautiful spacious suites, big picture windows, great city views, well worth asking for a room on the south side of the building to get the best of those views, minimalist bathrooms, and also the mini bar packed with sort of local specialties, which is a really nice touch. So that's well worth a look. Over in West Perth, just opposite Kings Park, you've got the new Tribe Perth. Now, wow, I think this hotel is really redefining what a hotel stay actually means. So much fun. The minute you walk in the front door, you know you're in for something special. It's pretty much targeted at young urban travellers, but I think anybody is going to enjoy this experience. It's got a bit of a touch of the Austin Powers going on about it. It's a bit fun and funky. Up in the guest rooms, those beautiful signature Tribe beds, glass-walled bathrooms, smart TVs, free Wi-Fi, all of the bells and whistles. But downstairs, they've got this sensational shared communal area, which has got a lounge area, workspaces, a communal bar and restaurant, all of this sort of stuff. And it's a space that you actually want to spend time in. So definitely worth having a look. It's something a bit different. That's Tribe Perth.
All right, excellent. Some great places there. Now, the Perth dining scene also has a lot to offer. What are some of the absolute must-tries whilst you're in town?
Yeah, so Como the Treasury, of course, is Perth's nod to six-star hotel luxury. It's also the city's premier dining destination. A couple of experiences there, if you haven't checked them out already. The first one is Wildflower up on the roof. What an extraordinary place to eat. I think this is one of the most culturally significant culinary experiences anywhere in the country. It draws on the six locally recognised indigenous seasons, so the menu reflects those seasons. The ingredients are either cultivated or foraged. The menu is just superb. If you can't decide what to try, have a look at the chef's five-course tasting menu. But an impeccable wine list, great service, views of the city, all of combined to create to make this a pretty special dining experience. It's well worth a look. Down in the basement, you've got David Thompson's Long Chim. Of course, Long Chim opened in Sydney last year, and of course in Melbourne earlier this year. But the Perth venue has really taken the city by storm. It's all about Bangkok street food inspired fare. They bring over authentic spices from Thailand, combine them with local ingredients. And even though it has one of the poshest addresses in town, this is a dining experience that's really accessible and just about anybody will enjoy. So definitely worth a look while you're in town. That's Long Chim.
All right, well, while you're eating away through some of those amazing restaurants, you want to be checking out some of the attractions as well. And I know that the Western Australian Museum in Perth, it's currently closed for renovation. I think they're planning to reopen in 2020. Is that right?
And
tell us about some of the other must-sees in the inner city at the moment.
Yeah. For sure. Well, look, I've got to say, the Western Australian Museum looks like it will be absolutely stunning when it does reopen in 2020. It's a couple of years away, obviously. In the meantime, have a look at the Museum of Perth. Now, this was a complete surprise to me. It's located right in the city centre. I didn't even know it existed. Of course, other cities around the world have got museums dedicated to cities. The Museum of London is probably the gold standard, as is the City of New York. But here in Australia, it's less common. Brisbane has one, and so does Perth, as it turns out. It's in the historic Atlas Building just down on the Esplanade opposite the Elizabeth Quay development. That's also well worth a look while you're in town. But the Museum of Perth does specially curated exhibitions dedicated to various chapters in Perth's history. I found it so interesting. It's a small place, but well worth a look. So definitely check that one out. If you're still young enough to remember what it's like to go out for a night on the town, I'm sure you probably are, Leanne. I'm getting a little bit long in the tooth. But the small bar boom in Perth is just phenomenal. This has all come about from the changes to liquor licensing laws back in 2007, which have seen the rise of the small bar in Perth. These are bars with a maximum capacity of 120 people, must serve food, must keep music low in the background. So many interesting ones to check out around the city. If you're not sure where to start, there's a walking tour company called 2 Feet and a Heartbeat, which will take you on a bit of a guided stroll to some of the most interesting options. I absolutely loved it. So well worth doing that as well.
And all of this really to try and sort of reinvent and bring the city alight, isn't it, ahead of that that bicentenary that we mentioned there. And there's a big focus on trying to lure a lot of Asian travellers as well, isn't there?
Yeah, there's just been an announcement this week that Perth will try and lure more Asian air carriers to the city. Of course, we're seeing Qantas commence their direct flights, as James said, from Perth to London next year. Mm. But certainly there's a move to entice more Asian carriers to the city. Really, the bicentenary is, you know, a fair way off. We're still talking another decade, but certainly Perth is hard at work trying to reinvent the city centre, breathe new life into it, and they're doing a fantastic job, I've got to say. It's really exciting.
Yeah, it seems like they are. As you say, a lot of great places to stay, things to do, places to eat as well. Look, Adam, we'll leave it there. It's been a pleasure talking to you. We appreciate you taking us through all of that.
My pleasure, Leanne. Anytime.